But and that was actually our first fucking victory today in the BMD2. Holy shit. Hey. But the vehicles that can set up to, well, it's sort of like, it's basic MMO logic, really. It's, you have the tank, which is usually your main battle tank, funny enough, out in front soaking up all the damage. You have your damage dealers, like, you know, like, well, your fighters, I suppose. In the, way in the back, you know, shooting at shit, direct fire. And I suppose artillery also qualifies as that. So you get your fighters and your wizards in the second line. And then skulking around, actually, no, not even, it's not even skulking around. They're also on the second line of all the invisible scout tanks that just sort of poke at things. There's only really two lines, and the artillery kind of gets away with it being on the second line because it's usually in a place where no one can actually see it because of its firing angles. The rogue types, or the recon vehicles, they're invisible, so it doesn't really matter. They can't see them. So, oh, we got a crate too. Well, at least there's that. But the second line vehicles that aren't, like, I don't know, the direct fire snipers, those are the ones that get fucked most often. I mean, yeah, the Centauro did really well in that match back there, but that's because it's probably the most hospitable for that type of vehicle. But let's see what we get out of the crate. Money, a low tier for maintenance kit, insignias. Alright. We're actually gonna slap that on, because we're actually grinding something. How many matches? One match.
Wow, amazing.
If there's, you know, big flat open fields, wide lines of fire, you're gonna do well in a vehicle that's designed for sniping. If you get into a claustrophobic situation with a sniping vehicle, unsurprisingly, and if you don't have any armor, you're gonna get fucked. And, you know, in a lot of other situations, let's take the engine one up. We're not gonna be able to buy it. Things get really expensive really fast in this game. But the situation is that, you don't take sniping vehicles to, to claustrophobic maps. Just like, you can totally get around. No, you really can't. Because you're trying to grind through these vehicles. It's not just like having a character select screen as soon as you come into the, it's not like playing Overwatch or something like that, and it's based on map. It is, you see the maps, you can sort of plan for that, but the problem is you're trying to grind a specific vehicle and you don't really have any control over what kind of maps you're going to get. You can see them beforehand in the map screen, unlike World of Tanks, but you can't, you have to go in there. If you want to grind the vehicle like this right now, I have to play this vehicle. There is no way of getting around this, aside from if I just throw money at it. You have to play this, and you have to go through whatever contracts for whatever PvE missions you want. You actually, not even want, you get. So, in that case, the map design needs to get fixed so we can probably, yeah, there you go. There's the other thing. I suppose that's what I was tracking through, while I was talking about the, what to do to fix this for the other vehicle, for lightly armored vehicles, because you don't really have any armor. The map design needs to get better. It needs to be more open. There's a lot of claustrophobic nonsense in this map, and it doesn't really need to happen in a lot of cases. So everything's kind of hemmed in, and when things are hemmed in, the lighter vehicles have to get closer in order to really do anything, or they just sort of sit in the back and don't accomplish fucking anything. I say that, and there are lightly armored vehicles that do better, such as the scout vehicles. However, there are vehicles like, for example, the BMPs and the BMDs. The BMDs are sort of like a middle ground between the scout vehicles and the APCs, I suppose, the IFEs. Those vehicles are sort of like These are, like, I consider, like, for example, the Warrior is another one. The Warrior is not a recon vehicle. Or it's not technically supposed to be a recon vehicle because it's not, you know, it's probably classed as one because people see the T-15 IFV as a recon vehicle, even though that's not really what that should be. What they are, or at least what I think they should be in terms of, like, how their what their role is in the game is DPM output machines. But the only problem is they can't... You can't stand out in the line of fire in order to deal that DPM, or you will get shot. And because you have no armor, the shots will always go through and cause damage. So it's kind of unsustainable. So what you really need to do is you either need to make those shots hurt less, or, you know, fix something about those shots where if I step out of cover and start laying down fire on something, there's going to be less of a chance that the return fire is actually going to hit me, or you need to, well, fix the map design so you can do the same thing. Like, I suppose the ideal example would be, take me and this chieftain right here. Chieftain's not really the most armored thing in the world. That's a Leopard A5. You see, this is what I'm talking about. As soon as I deal with this guy, I'll be able to actually tell you, but now I'm gonna... He missed. Huh. Okay. We got lucky there. We got really lucky there. That only one of those shots actually hit us. But that's the exception, rather. That's not really what you should be expecting. Usually you don't want to step out of fucking cover. But honestly, like, for example, take me in this chieftain, for example. The chieftain doesn't really have a lot of armor, but it can sort of stand out and fight with the main battle mechs. Nice. I didn't pen you, though. You're fine. But really what should be happening is the main battle tank should be in the front, and then something like the BMD or the Warrior or the BMP, for example, should be mostly right behind it as a basically just dealing DPM, just being a fortress for, well, not really a fortress for defense, but a fortress for just damage output. However, it's exceptionally hard to actually really do that, or actually really get that to happen, because the AI has a tendency to focus the least armored and the least hit point vehicles, which is always going to be you in the lighter vehicle. And if you get focused in one of these things, you're dead. So, there are some situations, like right now, where I'm able to skirt around because other people are grabbing aggro from these guys. But in a lot of cases, you can't really act on your own. And the other vehicles, and that's kind of unfair in a way, because all of the other vehicles can do that. The scout vehicles can act on their own because they're fucking invisible. The main battle tanks can act on their own because they're armored to fucking back and they can actually take a shot, so it doesn't really matter to them. The IFVs and all the vehicles in the middle can't really do that. They rely on the other vehicles for support, and because of that, they're always going to do worse. Or almost always going to do worse, except for, you know, except the situations like the last map that we have and the example with the Centauro, that the map design is more accommodating to basically a sniping whoring vehicle. Like, I would love to be, you know, I would love to be, you know, have this sort of, like, be this sort of, like, beefy, you know, I'm made of cardboard, but I could sort of, like, sit there behind a main battle tank and just dump shells on something with an autocannon, which is what I want to do in the Warrior as soon as I get it.
Enemy destroyed. Identify target.
Uh-oh. Ah! We're getting lucky this game. I suppose my complaining is reaching the ears of the dice bots. Red light requesting fire at target. Someone kill the Challenger 2, please. Target destroyed. Or Challenger 1. No effect. Nope. I don't think the designate target ability is really all that useful either. Yeah, sure, I'm not using it terribly often, but other people will say that no, it's totally useful. You can do, you know, you increase the damage of the shot. You get maximum dice rolls every time you use it on the target. However, it takes too long to set up. And it kind of, it makes the particularities of this type of vehicle and the abilities, or like the and the, you know, the restraints of the abilities kind of force you to play really hands off, and I don't really like that. Yeah, sure, you know, things need to be, you know, in certain games, well, actually no, in all games, you need to have roles that function differently. However, this is kind of excruciating in the face of the other things that I could be playing, like main battle tanks, which should probably tell you something about why there are so fucking many main battle tanks in the game right now. For example, look at this match. We have me and an IFV, an artillery piece, and three main battle tanks. I wonder what everyone's playing. So, yes, it should be different. However, the different right now isn't terribly fun. It's plainly obvious to see. So, something's gotta change here. And of course, we're all waiting because this is another, whatchamacallit, I suppose, a tradition, or a, what's the term? I can't think of it right now. I'll just fucking do it. Identify target. For obvious reasons, like I said in the last video, yeah, you don't step on the cap unless everybody's ready, because it spawns a new wave of dudes. I don't really like when games... Ow, there's a shot that hit us and did fuckloads of damage. Now, you see... Well, we lost the M60. I suppose we're just gonna have to carry this ourselves by staying on this point right now, because this is kind of a dub. But then again, the M60 had to As you see, that's one of the situations where it's fairly useful. However, it takes fucking forever to set up. Damn it, that was one of ours. Low WP. Good Goyim. And now we're out of AP. But whatever, we'll get by. But yeah, like that. It takes for the IFV ability takes forever to set up, and you're already kind of hiding, so you're not in an optimal you're not in an optimal position to do damage or output damage like I believe that these types of vehicles should do. So you're always going to be behind the other vehicles in terms of damage, because you're never going to get to the fight first, and you're never going to be initiating a fight. Whoa. Except in very rare circumstances, such as this. Fucking do it! Just do it! Just fucking reload before he starts shooting me. Ah! Okay. We're just gonna step off the point here for a little bit so we can get some more points because we're a working man. We're trying to make a living. Hey, I'm actually not doing terribly bad in damage. There we go. All that complaining and I actually managed to do pretty okay. This is what I get for not really paying attention. But the thing is, I may be doing okay, but I'm not having fun while I'm doing okay. That's kind of the point that I'm trying to get. It's summoning up all the complaining, which may be incorrect, but it's summoning up complaining to begin with. But what do I know? I'm not a game designer. I just play terrible games on the internet. But I have these need something. They need something that lets them do more, not more damage, sort of like, what if they gave IFVs the focus ability that tank destroyers have? Not necessarily for reducing their camouflage value, but for increasing their rate of fire. Just lots and lots of burst damage. Especially the autocannon ones. I'd be fucking ridiculous with autocannons. Let's see what we get in the crate. Free XP. All right, very good. See, that's nice. I like that you get free XP out of this, even though oil is... That's another thing that I really don't like about this game, that it kind of I feel shackled with. Mobility means jack shit in this game. To put it very, very bluntly. Because mobility, what does mobility do? Especially in a PvE sense, and you notice I'm treating the game almost entirely like a PvE game, because PvP is absolutely unreliable at this point, you can't really play it. But in a PvE sense, mobility means almost nothing. Because the AI are snapshot kings. They're a lot better now than they were originally. Fuck, it was impossible to play anything lightly armored. But they still hit you, and it still hurts a lot. So, and you know, they, as you saw while I was playing Starry Night the first fucking time, or Stormy Winter the first fucking time, they were all waiting for me. Twice. They all staring in my general direction. As soon as I poke out to try and shoot them, they all shoot me. With the AI being as alert as it is, mobility just gets you shot. Trying to fire and maneuver just exposes you. What's far more effective is just sitting and waiting in cover. And then just sort of hoping that your teammates sort of nudge the enemy out of position, grab their attention, and, you know, for you to just sort of, like, poke out and shoot something. We actually did fairly well that last game, but still, you're not the star here, and that annoys me. There's not a whole lot of ways for an IFV to actually be a star. I mean, whatchamacallit. And also, someone in the last video pointed out the BMD4, and honestly, the BMD4 was always overperforming in terms of being an IFV, and Obsidian even said it and then nerfed it, but it's still really good. So that one will be, you know, that one will be all right. And the Bradley, from all that I've seen and all that I've heard for the Bradley is nice. It's not amazing, but it's nice.
If that's the case, our jets are in trouble.
But I think they need to just sort of refocus IFVs towards being damage dealers. Or sort of, like, well, they need to find a way for the second line damage dealer to actually really be the star of a show in a lot of cases. Because main battle tanks don't really need support. They can just blunder off into everywhere and they'll be fine. And honestly, in a lot of cases, the best support for a main battle tank is another main battle tank. Where did that go? Did that just fire into the ground? Holy shit, this launcher really... Also, the launcher system is kind of witty.
Intel
what?
Was right. That's gotta be one of the
you saw that, right? You guys saw that, right?
Take them all out.
Phase missiles.
No effect.
For example, I'd love to move into a better firing position with this guy. The only problem is, as soon as I step the fuck out, I'm gonna get shot. And I don't have a lot of hit points to spare, and in this kind of, in this, the way the PvE missions get laid out with the vehicles, with, you know, AI spawning and stuff like that, you need those hit points. And obviously you need to stay alive in any other mode, but longevity is the most important thing in PvE, I find. Being able to subsist through all of the enemy spawns and all of the damage is the most important thing, and you do that one of two ways. You do that either by being invisible, or you do that by having shit tons of armor and being untouchable. But now I'm just repeating myself. I've been rambling for like half an hour. Looks like it could be a good spot to set up. Not necessarily because of all the rear spawns behind us, but for the forward ones. And I may have been a little bit harsh about saying that mobility is worthless, but for a lot of vehicles, mobility doesn't really help. And in most cases, the vehicles themselves are much better off just sitting in cover, not being shot, rather than trying to fire and maneuver against AI, who are snapshot kings. Honestly, what I want to see is, I want to see something new. Because obviously, the immediate brain dead decision for fixing this situation where IFVs can't really do anything, or IFVs are, are the least capable of all the vehicles, is to buff their camouflage value. And I don't want to see that, because I think that's lazy, and I think there's a better way around that.
Access the hard drive remotely, but need time to download the intel.
And there are whatchamacallit. There are, like, for example, there are sort of hits in the whatchamacallit.
Intel's been downloaded.
Well, game over. There are smaller things in play. Like, for example, IFVs that are troop carriers get bonuses to capturing speeds. Maybe something in that regard. Something that can. What if you could deploy troops? That'd be kind of interesting. You'd probably have to raise the age rate because people are dying in front of the screens and we are no longer, you know, machine spirits or whatnot. But something interesting like that. Something that helps the vehicle cause damage in an indirect way. Sort of like, that'd be interesting, like a minion thing. But that'd be a lot. That's a whole new layer of fucking shit that you have to put into the game, and that's a lot of work. So then it's not about playing a vehicle. It's about micromanaging squads. Though wouldn't it be kind of cool to just sort of like be able to carry around a squad of like Panzer Grenadiers, for example, just sort of stop, have them get out, and just sort of point like have the target designator like the have the designation ability sort of. Laser a target for them. It's in addition to having everybody else's dice rolls or in exchange for having that, having everybody's dice rolls, you know, at maximum, it sort of acts as a marker for the squad to go, it's like, hey, go shoot that. That'd be kind of interesting. And that's complicated. And it's like, I know that game designers, if they hear this, are probably like, how the fuck would you even code that? Like, how the hell would you even present that to a player? And that's kind of the main issue that people don't really take into account when they suggest new ideas for video games. Because, you know, it's like, that's a nice concept. The only problem is you look at the game and like, okay, so how the hell do we do that? So that's why, like, 70% of the ideas that you find cool about video games don't actually work, because it's not actually possible for the developers to actually implement it. But I'd like to see something like that. Something interesting, something unique, and also something strong. Like, or not like, maybe not, maybe, whatchamacallit. They're putting in for, global operations. They're putting in, the one map that they showed off has AI bunkers that shoot ATGMs at tanks. What if you could fortify an area like that? Like, what if you could, like, you know, whatchamacallit, what if you could, like, for example, what if I pressed E right now, and the camera backed up slightly, and it gave me a radius, and in that radius I could put down, like, a pillbox. Not a really big pillbox, but a sandbag fortification, something like that. Either an ATGM or a machine gun or something like that. That'd be neat. But again, I know, backseat game design. Idea, guys. Whoa. Okay, let's try to fucking... Like, for example, in PvE that would actually be extraordinarily useful. Like, for example, I could hit something and then it'd be like hitting control. Like, you get your mouse and then I could put an ATGM launcher here. And it would watch this road. No pen. But you get the idea, more or less. Something new and interesting, and not just making it invisible. And something that's actually, you know, entertaining for, you know, not necessarily, probably not entertaining because it's causing you frustrations for other players, I suppose. But something, you know, interesting and you don't really see in other games, that for other people to, you know, fight against. That works in a PvP setting as well. I mean, you're gonna have to work the balance a little bit in order to get it to work and not make people, like, just sort of, you know, not people, get pissy about it, but it works in a PvP situation. You can fortify positions. And hey, it gives you another reason to shoot it, to load high explosive to deal with fortifications. So yeah, I suppose what I was asking for there is make troop carrier IFDs basically the TF2 engineer. What? Well, why not? They're troops. This is what infantry does in modern warfare. They fortify positions. And I suppose having an ability like that also, I like that idea now. I hope they do that. If Obsidian, if you're listening, consider that. But I suppose it also takes the, whatchamacallit, it takes the emphasis, it takes the direct emphasis of the commander of the IFE to put his vehicle in hilarious danger by trying to compete with other direct combat vehicles in the manner which I am doing now. of which there are so many vehicles in this game that are already better than me at that, like light tanks and scout vehicles. So if it carries troops, make it sort of like, make it more, like, if you're carrying troops, you're gonna be, your vehicle is basically managing those troops. So why not just make it sort of a, well, make it like a, what, like a City of Heroes, Mastermind, that kind of thing, minions, like I said. Of course, then you become a school bus driver, but then again, you're driving an infantry fighting vehicle. You're already driving a school bus. It seems to be going well, but then again, everything else was going well in the other game up until the game ended. That SAM launcher is down there, so I'm gonna go drive down there next. CryEngine, what the fuck are you doing? I didn't see nothing in that road. Where's this thing? Well, I didn't make it. Whoops, I went the wrong way. Oh, I'm terrible at managing secondary objectives. Like, but you see this, I'm doing, like, yeah, I've done absolutely no damage because, well, the fighting is very, 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 very hot and in very, in a very, very small confined space. Like, it'd be nice, you know, like using the turret idea, I could have just drove, like, in the beginning of the game, I could have just driven down there, slapped a few turrets down, and then driven off to go do the secondary objectives, like I am doing right now. Then I'm still technically in the fight and contributing to the fight, but also doing the things that the other vehicles aren't terribly, you know, well adverse to. Because I am a faster vehicle, though this thing isn't terribly fast in comparison to most of the vehicles in this game. It's faster than a main battle tank. That's not working. Ow, 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 ow. Ow, 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 ow. One more to go. We're just gonna use that now. Activate the self-defenses. Way over there. BMD4's got that. Whoops. I'm out of ammo. Ow! 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 What the fuck? Like, for example, the BMD is actually a little bit better off in terms of being able to do this stuff. Because it's smaller, the BMP is absolutely frustrating to drive in certain situations. So giving it ability that doesn't rely, giving it, you know, a strength that doesn't actually rely on it using its main gun would be actually quite helpful. Because the using a BMP-1 or a BMP-2 is sort of like using a big, fat, shirtless barbarian. Like, the damage output for those vehicles is really good to compensate for the fact that they have no armor and they're huge and absolutely unwieldy. And because of where the turret is, their gun depression angles are really shit. So you kind of have to drive out directly into the fight in order to fucking do anything. And you're gonna take damage, and damage... You're gonna take fire, and fire that is also always gonna cause damage because... you are a massive target and you have no armor. And also, yeah, nice job on that fucking missile. God damn, I hate when those fucking things are up there like that. Eight damage. Whee! Looks like we're actually gonna win this. I hope. Nope. Well, there you go.
Successful. Good job, Black Company.